Hello and welcome to part 4 on how to create the Reddit UI with React.js. In this part, I will show you how to create the community section. We'll start by creating a title, then we'll create communities, and at the end, I'm going to show you how to add the action buttons to the cart. So let's get started. So to get started, I'm going to open up the source folder, and inside of there, I'm going to create the sidebar. Inside the sidebar, I want to make the community section. So I'm going to create a new folder, community, and I'm going to create the components for it. Like so. And then create a function. And now that I have the component, I'm going to import it in our sidebar. So I want to say that I want to render the community section. So I'll say community, and it will automatically import it for me from the directory where we have created it. So if I save this up, it will compile. And after it's done compiling, we can go to the page and we will see our community section being rendered. So that's good. So the first thing that I see is that the community section is on the same height as the popular post. So I don't want that. I want the popular post to be a element above that. So to do that, I'm going to remove the popular post from the main bar. I'm going to get this away from here. And then I'm going in our content.tsx and I'm going to put it inside our bars wrapper. So if I refresh the page right now, we'll see that we have the popular post above it. So what is actually happening right here is that we applied display flex to the components. So everything will render next to each other, but we don't want that. We want this to render on a single line and those two components also on a single line. So to do that, I'm going to create a separate div for those components. I'm going to create it right here. And I want to remove the display flex from the bars wrapper. So right here, I don't want a display of flex, like so, but we do want it on the main section and the side section. So I'm going to say that we here have a bars wrapper inside, and that will have a display of flex, like so. And then we can see that this one is on a separate line, and this one will be on a different line. But as we can see, our font weight has been gone. So to add that back, I'm going to go into the CSS of the main bar and I'm going to copy over this font weight. Then I'll go into our content.css and I want to put it underneath the bars wrapper. So it's the first span inside the bars wrapper with this class. And I can remove the main bar class since it won't be in the main bar anymore. And right here we have the class name. If I save this up, we can see that this has the font weight back. So next up, I'm going to create the communities card. I'm going to save this up and then I'm going to edit our community component. Right here, I want to say that we have a class name of community section, like so. And then I'm going to look at which components we are going to use there. We have a title section right here. We have the communities, which is this one, and then we have the action buttons. So that will be three separate divs. I'm going to create a title. Then we have a separate div for the communities. And then another div for the action buttons. Like so. And if I save this up, we will see the three different sections appearing. I then want to give a background color to the communities div. So I'm going to say community section background color of white, like so. But as you can see, it is not taking the full width. So to fix this, I'm going to go into the sidebar component and I'm going to say that we want the sidebar to have a flex of 1. So I'm going to say dot sidebar and we'll say flex of 1. So it will take all the remaining space. And we actually applied flex 0.7 to this one. So we actually want flex 0.3 to that one, like so. And then we have our little section. And we maybe want to make it a little bit bigger. So I'm going to apply 0.4 right here. And into our main bar 0.6, like so. So that's looking a lot better. I then want to apply a little bit of margin between those two. So I'm going to say margin left on the sidebar of 50 pixels, something like that, maybe even less, 25 pixels, yes, I think that looks good, and I want to have it on the same height as the updates card, so I think that we put an margin top to it, so that was in our content. We had our popular post title, bar wrapper, main bar. We have our main bar, yes. So here we have our update card. And if I look at the CSS from that one, we'll see a margin top of 15 pixels. So that is what I'm going to apply to the sidebar as well. I'm going to say margin top of 15 pixels. So now it will be on the same height. And then I want to add a little border and yeah, a little bit of padding. So to do that, I'm going to say border radius of the same as the other card. So I'm going to grab the other card again, which is in the main bar.css. Here we have, we use the variable, so we will use it right here as well, like so. And then I want to apply a little border color. So that will be this one. And I'm going to put it underneath this one. So now we have a little border around it. And we are going to start on the title section. So for the title section, we want to create a div with the background image and then a absolute text, I think. So I'm going to close the files that we won't be needing. And then I'm going to open up the community tab. And inside of here, I'm going to put a span. And that will say today's top grown communities. So I'm going to just copy over this text right here. And then save it up. And we have our text right here. And I want to give this one a class name of title. So then I can target it by its title class name. And I want to give it a fixed height of something like 150 pixels. And I think I have to give it a min height. Or I have to write the Y at the end of here. Like so. So 150 is maybe too much. Maybe 100 pixels. Yes, I think that looks better. And then I want to apply the background image to the div. So I'm going to say that we have a background image, which will be of URL. And then we're going to say dot slash assets slash images slash community dot JPEG, like so. So the reason why it is not compiling is because our community image is named communities, like so. And the second reason is because we don't want to use the relative path, we want to use the absolute path, which will be in the public folder. So if we leave it like this, and at the before slash, we will get our image, like so. So now the image is being rendered inside our div. I then want to apply a color to the text. So I'm going to target the span inside of the div. I'm going to say span, and I want to target it directly span. And I'm going to say color of white, like so. I want a font weight of 600, like so. And then I want it at the bottom. So I'm going to apply a position of absolute, a bottom of 0 pixels, maybe 15 pixels. And then let's see, from the left, we also have something like that. So left is maybe a little bit more, 20 pixels. And right now we see it in the bottom corner of the page. So we still have to add the relative positioning to our title component. I'm going to say position relative. So right now everything inside of it is relative to the title div. So if we look at this, we will see our text being relative to it. So that's really good. I then want to create a little bit less space between the bottom and the left. So maybe something like this. Yes, that looks good. So I see that the border radius is not being applied correctly. I've made a mistake before. I added the border radius to our sidebar, and we actually don't want that. We want to have our border radius in the community card, so right here. And if I save this up now, we will see that the border radius is a lot more accurate, but at the top sections of the card it is not rendering the radius, and that is because we are creating an image right there and the image overlaps it the border radius, it ignores it. So I'm going to have to apply it manually right here. So border top left radius will be var border radius, and then the same for the top right, like so. And the reason why I'm not just saying border radius is because of this. If I type it right here, we will see that the card also has border radius at the bottom, and we don't want that. We want the image to float into the card nicely. So to remove this, we will see that it floats right into the card. So now that we have that done, I think I want to change the width of the card once more. It is a lot smaller on the Reddit page, so I'm going to decrease the flex value. I'm going to say that this will be 35 and this one will be 65. So if I save those two up, yes, it's smaller and I think it is more representative to the actual Reddit page. So now that we have that done, I want to decrease the height of the title section. So I'm going to go into the community.css and I'm going to say height of maybe 75 pixels, maybe 80 pixels. Yes, I think that looks better. And then we want to create the subreddit sections right here. And before we do that, I actually have to add the JSON for it. So to add that, I'm going into our data folder and I'm going to create a communities folder. And inside of here, I'm going to write communities.json. And then I'm going to paste in the JSON that I have already created before. So I'm going to save this up. And now we can use this JSON inside of our community component. And I'm going to import it right here. Import communities from. Oh, that's one too high. Data, communities, community.json, like so. And as you can see, the communities.json is already in the same type as we did in our training items.json. So it's like a subreddit class, so we don't have to worry about that one. So what I can do right now is I can just easily map those communities, and then I can target a single community with the index, and then I can wrap it in a div, and I can say community dot and then name, because as you can see, it already recognizes the two attributes of a community, so that is why we get those as suggested. So I'm going to say that we want to render the name, and if we look up the page right now, we will see all the names being rendered. So I'm going to need a couple more things to render our communities. I'm going to need the number, an icon, the image, and the span. So I'm going to create the number, which will be right here. I'm going to want an icon, then I want the image, and at last we want the subreddit name. So I'm just going to say community.name already, because we have it right here. So community.name, like so. And I put r/ before it, so it will render as a subreddit. So we see the subreddits appearing, and we have the spans appearing as well. The next thing I want to do is replace the number with the actual index. So when we map our communities, we get a second parameter, which is the index, and that is the current index which we are currently accessing. And in most programming languages, when you loop over a list, it starts with the index of 0. So if I render the index right here, we'll see 0, 1, 2, 3. So to get the list started with 1, I just have to add 1 to it. So I'm going to say index plus 1. and then we will see 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's really good. I'm then going to input the arrow upwards. I'm going to import it from the material UI. Arrow drop up from, and then arrow drop up like so. I'm going to use this right here. And if I refresh the page, we will see our arrow appearing. Then I want the image. The image will have the source of the community. So I can access that by saying community dot and then image source, like so. And right now we have every component. I made a little mistake. Image is img. So right now we have every little component that we need. We have the index, icon, image, and the subreddit itself. So I'm going to start by decreasing the size of the image. I'm going to do that by giving each community a class name. So I'm first going to give it a class name of communities wrapper, and then I'm going to give this a class name of community. So then I can target it by going into the community section and then going into the community wrapper, and I think it's communities wrapper, and then I'm going to target a single community. And in here I want to target the image, so I'm going to say max width of 16 pixels, and I'm going to copy that over for the min width, max height, and then the min height, like so. And if I refresh the page, we'll see our icon appearing. I think it will have to be a little bit bigger, so instead of 16 I'm going to say 32 pixels. Yes. And then we want to apply a border radius to it, so 50%, like so. So that is working already. I then want to create a display of flex in a community div, so everything will display next to each other, and then I can align everything vertically. So I'm going to say display flex, like so, and then I want to say align items center, like so. So that's working out really well. I want to make the span at the end a little bit bold, so I'm going into the communities and then targeting the last shot, and I'm going to give it a class name of community name, so this will be name, and then I can say that community dot name, and I want to say font weight of 600, like so. Now we have a little bit of bold font weight. And then I want to change the color of our icon. So I'm going to target that one by SVG. Like so. And I want the color of RGB, red, green, and blue. Like so. And maybe that is too light green. So to make it darker, I'm going to lower the green value, like 250. Like so. And maybe we want to make it a little bit lighter, 180, like this. So that looks good. I then want to move everything a little bit away from the left border. So to do that, I'm going to add a margin left of 15 pixels, like so, and maybe even 20 pixels, 25 maybe. Yes, so 25 is good, I think. I then want to apply a border top to every card. So I'm going to say in our community, I want a border top of 1 pixel solid. And then I want to apply the border radius that we have applied right here. Or I mean the border color. So that will be this one. I put it right here. So I'm going to say RGB 200, like so. And now we have a little border at the top. And I want to make it a little bit lighter, so it doesn't show up that much. Yes, and as you can see, it is starting 25 pixels from the left, and we don't want that. To make it start from the left at 0 pixels, I'm going to change this to padding. So right now it is starting from the total left, and then I want to add a little bit of padding to the top and the bottom of each community. So I'm going to say padding above here, and I want to say top 5 pixels, left 0 pixels, bottom 5 pixels, right 0 pixels. So the top and the bottom will have 5 pixels of padding, and I'm going to increase it to 8, like so. And then I think that we are done with the community section right here. To finish it up, I'm going to make every community hoverable. So I'm going to say right here that we want to be hoverable. So now when we hover over a community, we'll see the cursor. And I think that I actually want to do that with the text in the title as well. So I'm going to say that this pen will be hoverable, like so. And then we can hover over the title as well, like this. So the last thing to do is add the action buttons. And for the action buttons, I'm going to create two divs. I'm going to create one group div, a button, and then it's a next div for the small buttons. So right here, I'm going to say class name equals action buttons. And right here, I want a single button. So I'm going to import the button from our component, and then I'm going to give it a class name of primary. And I want to give it a label, and that will be view all, like so. And then when I refresh the page, I will see the button. And then I want to create the div where we will put the other buttons. So right here, we want 1, 2, 3, 4 buttons. So I'm just going to use normal buttons right now, and that will be sports, news, gaming, and AWW. AWWW. News. Oh, gaming and AWW. Yes. Okay, good. And the first thing I'm noticing is that the text is not centered in the button. And the next thing I'm noticing is that those buttons are not nice. So we are going to fix that right now. So before I'm going to fix it, I'm going to look at the Reddit page once more. And I'm going to just break down the different buttons that we have right here. In the upper right, I see a primary sign up button. Next to it, I see a secondary login button. Here I see a primary button right here as well. A couple of primary buttons. And I think I can classify those buttons as tertiary buttons. So we have a primary, secondary, and tertiary. And maybe we even want that for the hot and everywhere, but they don't show hoverable effects. So I'm just going to create those three buttons, primary, secondary, and tertiary. So I'm going to go into the button component, and I'm going to give it a third parameter, which will be secondary. And we're also going to give it a fourth parameter, which will be tertiary. And this will also be a boolean, like so. And by default, if we don't pass any parameter to it, it will render as a primary. And otherwise, it will render as the attribute that we pass in. So I'm first going to add those to the constructor right here. I'm going to say secondary and tertiary. And then I'm going to work on this. I'm going to say if the button is tertiary, then we want to return something. Else if it is secondary, then we want to return something. And else then it will be a primary button. Then we want to return this. So I'm going to copy this to here. The secondary, I'm going to copy it to here. I'm going to remove the old statement. And then I'm going to put this in the tertiary as well. So right now, if it is a tertiary button, it will also be rendered as a secondary button. If we save this up and we refresh the page, we will see that this one is being rendered as a primary button. So to fix that, I'm going to go into the navigation. I'm going in our actions component, and I'm going to add a secondary right here. So this doesn't need the primary tag anymore, because it will be primary by default. And then we have the secondary right here. And as you can see, it will render as a secondary button. The next thing I'm going to do is fix up the text alignment in the button. So in our button.css, I'm going to say that we want a text line of center. So right now, the button text is being centered, just like right here. And I want to change those with the tertiary button. So in our community, I'm going to copy over this. And then I want to copy it 4 times, like so. And instead of primary, I'm going to say tertiary, like so. And I'm then going to apply the labels, like so. News, gaming, and AWW, like so. And then we will see our buttons appearing beneath each other. But I don't want them beneath each other. I want to make them appear next to each other. So I'm going to say class name is secondary buttons, like so. And I'm going to target it by the secondary buttons. So I don't have a action components section yet. So let's see, we have the action buttons that action buttons, right? Community section, action buttons, yes, and then secondary buttons, that secondary buttons. And that will have a display of flex, like so. But as you can see, it is expanding the width. So to fix this, I'm going to add a flex wrap to it. So when it exceeds the maximum width, it will wrap to the next line. So I'm going to say flex wrap of wrap, like so. But now they are beneath each other, and we don't want that. But that is what we are going to fix when we create the new button, the tertiary button, because this button will be a lot smaller than the other buttons. So I'm going to go into our button component, and I'm going to give this a tertiary button class, like so. And then I want to add it right here, tertiary button. And if we refresh this, we'll see that no styling is being applied. And I want a light gray background. And I think I want the same background as with the search bar. And in the last episode, I have added a variable for that one. And that was light gray. So I'm going to reuse that. And I'm going to say background color of light gray. And remove a select tunnel. So now we have a light background color. I want the text inside of it to be of primary color. So it will have the primary color. I want to remove the border color. So border will be none, like so. And then I want to make them a lot smaller. So I'm going to override the normal padding. Instead of a padding of 7 pixels and 35, I'm going to just say padding of 7 pixels, like so. And I think 7 pixels is a little bit too small, so I'm going to up it up. I'm going to say 7 pixels and maybe 10 pixels, something like that. Or maybe, no, I think this will be good. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to apply some styling to the community. I'm going to say that we want to display them not next to each other, but spread out. So just for content and then stretch or space between, like this one. And I also want them to be a little bit more removed from the border. So I'm going to add a padding to that as well. And I'm actually going to add the padding to the whole action button section, because the view all button also has to be a little bit from the sidebar. And to do that, I'm going to look into our title. And I see that we have a left of 15 pixels. So that is what I also want to add to our action buttons. I'm going to say that we want a padding of top 0 pixels and then horizontally 15 pixels, like so. So that's really good. And then I want to target the first button. So I'm going to say this. And then I want to target our first button, or I'm going to be more specific, our first primary button, which is a direct child. And I'm going to say margin bottom of 15 pixels, like so. And maybe even more, 20 pixels. Yes. And actually, instead of doing that, I'm going to add a margin top of 15 pixels, like so. And I want to add the margin to our secondary buttons. So I'm going to just say margin 0 pixels, 15 pixels, with a space between them, like so. And I meant 15 and then 0. Yes, like so. So now we have the spacing between the buttons, above and beneath the buttons. So that's really good. The last thing I want to do is add a hoverable effect to our tertiary buttons, so that when we hover over it, it will get the dark background. So I'm going into our button.css, and I'm going to say when we hover over it, I want to change the background color to RGB, something like 100, 100, 100, like this. And it's way too dark. Let's see. Maybe we do use that color even more than I already think. No, I don't think so. So I'm just going to look up what color that was, the light gray color. I'm going into our app.css 245. So I think I'm going to keep it as 240. Yes. Oh, wait, there was a Reddit page. Okay. So I think that's maybe even too light. Yes. Yeah, okay. Yes, this is really good. We have the almost the same background color when we hover over it. And with this, we have recreated the top today's Chrome communities. We have created the title section right here, the separate communities, which are right here, the view all button, which we have, and then the tertiary buttons with the categories, which we have right here. So I'm really happy with the results. I hope you could follow along and that you've learned something. Next time I want to create the posts, which will be the biggest part of this tutorial. And I hope I see you next time. Bye.